Microsoft Excel contains a number of database functions that are available and will assist you in extracting information from your database. In this segment, you'll learn how to find and activate the functions, set up your spreadsheet to facilitate using the database functions, and using these functions. Here we have a simple database where we've got some information about trees, the name, its height, age, yield, and profit. And what we want to do is extract some information. So count how many trees meet certain conditions, add up certain information depending on some conditions. The important thing about database functions is that it allows you to actually specify the criteria within the spreadsheet itself. So just to give you an example, what we need to do is take the headings that we've got here. We can just copy them and paste them here. And now what we can do is we can specify certain criteria to pull through. So let's say I want to look at apple trees and I want the height, let's say, to be bigger than 10. This will now allow you to use functions to use these criteria to pull information out of this database. Let's try a simple function for now. We just want to count how many of the trees here are apple trees which are bigger than 10. So if you click on the function wizard and you go to the database section, you'll see there's one called DCOUNT. When I click OK, the first criteria is where is the database. So we just highlight the entire database. And you make it absolute by clicking the F4 key. It then asks for the field. And you can see it says a field is either the label of the column in double quotation marks or a number that represents the column's position in that list. In this case, I'm going to use height. So I put double quotes, height. Now the criteria, it says, is the range of cells that contain the conditions you specify. The range includes a column label and one cell below the label for a condition. So in that case, I want to highlight this section over there. And what we're saying is look at these conditions and apply that to the database. So when I say OK, you'll see it tells me 2, which when you look here, here's an apple tree, but it's 8, so it doesn't meet the one condition. Here's an apple 14, here's an apple 18. So there are 2 trees that meet these conditions. Now that you have this formula set up, it's quite convenient because this at the moment looks at those conditions. But let's say I go here and I change that to pair. When I click enter, you'll see that goes to 1 because there's only one tree that is a pear tree and is bigger than the 10. Similarly, we could go here and change that to be bigger than 8. And that will change to 2. So you've got a function that goes through the database and checks to certain criteria that exist in the spreadsheet and gives you the result. Now let's introduce another complexity. Let's say we want to know how many pear trees are bigger than 8, and we actually want to know how many apple trees are bigger than 10. In order to make this function work, we click on FX, we'll count them. Again, we specify the database. The field, in this case, instead of typing height, I can also say 2, which is the second column. And now for the criteria, I can actually highlight all of these and say OK. And what you'll see, it gives me an answer of 4. And that's because there are 2 pear trees bigger than 8, and there are 2 apple trees bigger than 10. The trick to understanding what this is doing is that anything that's included along the row is the equivalent of an AND function, and anything that's included down a column is the equivalent of an OR function. So you'll see here we're saying it's a pear tree and it must be bigger than 8. If we go down, we're saying it can be a pear tree or an apple tree. So for example, we can actually introduce another condition. Let's say we wanted it to be a pear tree bigger than 8 but less than 11. I can then come here, type the word height, and put the function less than 11. So now, when I do my function, you'll see I'll highlight the whole section, and what it's going to do is look here and say it must be pear and bigger than 8 and less than 11, or an apple that is also bigger than 10. So let's just do that function. Again, the database, the field is number 2, criteria. In this case, I'm going to highlight this entire area. And when I say OK, you'll see it gives me 3 now. And the reason it gives me 3 is because there's one pear tree that's bigger than 8 but less than 11, because this one doesn't match. And the apple, bigger than 10, there's 1, 2. Hence the answer is 3. So it's incredibly important to remember that you can specify and type criteria along the rows and or type criteria down the columns. And you can duplicate the columns if you've got more criteria you want to put in. We can now work through some of the other database functions, and it will hopefully show you how this all works. Let's say we want to find out which tree between apple and pear have the maximum profit. Click on a cell, activate the function wizard, and go to the database functions, to the dmax function. Again, we need to identify the database, specify the field, in that case it's going to be profit, so I'll use that. And the criteria I want to use here is just pear and apple. So I'm going to just highlight this section to say, look, either pear or apple. When I say OK, you'll see it gives me a number of 105, which is the maximum profit between pear and apple trees. Another useful function is the DSUM function. What we want to know is, what is the total profit for the pear trees? So I click on a cell, activate the function wizard, find DSUM, say OK, show it where the database is, tell it what field we're looking at, in this case it's a profit field, and specify the criteria, and in this case I'll just highlight these two. And when I say OK, it gives us 172.8, which is the total of that plus that. There are other database functions. So just to give you an idea, we can just have a quick look through here. They all use the same criteria. Whatever the function is, you show where the database is, you specify the field, either with the number or the name, and then you give the criteria in this sort of format. So using that, you can get an average of a database selection. You can count all the numbers. You can count the non-blanks. You can get particular information out of a database. You can get the maximum number, the minimum number. You can get it to multiply all the numbers that it finds. You can get a standard deviation based on a sample, standard deviation based on the entire population. We've been through the DSUM. You can get the variance, and the variance based on the population. And using these functions, you can basically extract all sorts of useful information out of a database.